turn to his book, chapter 3, verse 5. Amen. The Bible says, and Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. He says, I read it again, this is the King James version. If you have a different translation, mine is a little bit different. He says, and Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourselves. He said, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders. Another translation says, Joshua told the people, consecrate, that's the meaning of sanctify. Set yourself aside for God. He said, because the Lord will do wonders among you tomorrow. The Lord will do wonders among you tomorrow. The Lord will do wonders among you tomorrow. Can I ask for a little bit of a comment? If you were reading Bible at home on any day, maybe yesterday, and you read this, Joshua chapter 3, verse 5, he said, Joshua told the people, consecrate yourselves, because God or the Lord will do wonders among you tomorrow. What will come to you? Can we get another mic? Thank you. I want to hear at least two comments. What I'm trying to say is, what can you make up from this verse? What do you understand? What can you understand? We normally do this on Tuesday. Those of you that don't come on Tuesday, we normally have people to come, ask members to comment. But I'm doing a little bit of Sunday today. What can you infer? In chemistry, say, what's the inference? What can you get from here? Oh, sister, almost want to speak. No, before you spoke,
no,
before
no,
you
spoke.
I told you I wanted to speak. Okay, praise the living Jesus. Who want to comment on that verse? Well, there are a lot of things you can say. At least you can see the name Joshua. The pastor can see Joshua. That's a comment. Okay. What can you say? Ramon is lifting his hand. Wait, Ramon is normally, you normally go on Tuesday. Let's come get somebody. To say something. What's his sister? What's your name? Hello. Hello, ma. Praise God. What's your name again? Mine. Tina. Praise God. I see you're reading and you're very, very focused on what you're reading. Can you comment? Joshua 3:5. Is there anything that you want to say on that verse? And Ron Lou, you didn't get right to.
Actually,
you were also very serious.
What I heard there is that we should be confident of what we are about to do.
We should be confident of what we are about to do so that we're able to do it. When I read it, I didn't see that. He said we should be confident of what we are about to do so that we're able to do it. Give to God. Remember, what can you see? Joshua 3 verse 5. What can you see? What's the Lord speaking to you from that verse? I should give him some minutes. Give him some minutes. Kisby is the member of the executive believers class. He's a very similar member. What can you see from that verse? Hallelujah. It's good to see you this afternoon. Praise God. I see also give you some meaning. Okay, brother, just give it to me. What can you do? Say that again.
Declare or dedicate yourself. Dedication.
Dedication. Okay. Brother said you can see dedication. So give to God. God is another Bible scholar. God, what can you see? Joshua 3 verse 5. What's he talking about? Someone says confident about something. Well, let's just talk about commitment, dedication. What can you see from Joshua 3 verse 5?
It's always ready.
Sorry?
It's always be ready.
Always be ready.
Always be prepared.
Okay, because they just told the people, consecrate yourself because tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. How so do you see that? So someone is saying tomorrow God is going to do wonders. It means be expectant. It means be ready. And thank you. See? A lot of pastors here this afternoon. He said be ready. And that's true. I didn't see that before. Be ready because he said God is going to do, if God is going to do wonders, you better be expectant. If you are not expectant, then you miss it. Praise God. Who has asked, who see, who has seen some of this? At least three of few people have spoken up. The anointing should be strong on everybody. Okay, Sister Chidin Mountain Song. Glory to God. Just help me understand. Hallelujah.
It means dedicate yourself to something of greatest importance.
Dedicate yourself to something of great importance. Commit yourself to something of great importance. Okay? I like that. So those two folks who talked about commitment, they focused on the first two lines. When Joshua told the people, he said, consecrate yourselves. Consecrate yourself means dedication, it means commitment. In this case, it was a course, something they were about to do. And someone had said, because the Lord will do wonders among you, which means be expectant. And Sister Tina talks about being confident, being confident. Every one of these comments is right. That's the glorious thing about in my Bible. When you read the Word of God, God speaks to all of you differently. When you read the Word of God, you get different revelations, really. If we pick this part of the Bible and read it next Sunday, you'll be amazed that a lot of you might even get a different inspiration. But this morning or this afternoon, I want to share with you on committing God to perform. How you can commit God to perform. How you can commit God to perform. What am I talking about this afternoon?
Committing God to perform.
Oh, I guess it says the new one I speak English. The rest of you is not the Bible, you know? I said, what am I talking about this afternoon?
Committing God to perform.
Say it like English to you people.
Committing God to perform.
Praise God. Committing God to perform. It's so important, brothers and sisters, that you know as a child of God, you can actually commit God to your cause. A lot of us, we've done that without even knowing. A lot of us, we've done it accidentally. A lot of us, we've done it because we're pushed to the edge. We really have no option. And one way or the other, we committed God to perform an idea. But you must recognize that it's not an illegal thing to do. It's not a crime. If you wake up every morning and say, Lord, I'm going to commit you to a cause this month. And as a matter of fact, God actually loves you. God loves you. When you wake up as a son or a daughter and you decide to say, Lord, today is the 10th of September. It's a Monday morning. I'm going out now. You better be ready. Because I'm going to do some dangerous things. I'm going to act my faith this Monday morning, 10th of September. Be ready to back me up. When you do that, brothers and sisters, heaven and the scripture tells us that God is happy. When you read this Joshua chapter 3 verse 5, in addition to what Abraham has spoken, one of the things that comes to you is that number one, that Joshua, when Joshua was making that statement, he said, consecrate yourself unto God. Sanctify yourself, consecrate yourself. He said, for tomorrow, the Lord will do wonders amongst you. If you go and read, let me get it from verse 1 to verse 2, you find out that before Joshua made this statement, he had not talked to God. He had not said, God, I'm going to talk to your children, the children of Israel. Right? I'm going to say to them that tomorrow God will do wonders. You better be ready. No, he didn't do that. There was no place in the Bible where it was mentioned that Joshua first talked to God and said, God, I'm going to give this guy this news now. So don't let me down. You better be ready. Did any of that? So from that Joshua chapter 3 verse 5, you can see that it is okay when you commit God to your cause. Because when you do, you are actually acting your faith. When you do, you are actually challenging God. And each time you challenge God by acting your faith, by saying the same thing that Joshua said in his part of the Bible, when he said, God, consecrate yourself, for tomorrow, God is going to do a wonderful thing. God is going to do a glorious thing. The Bible tells us that God is activated to a cause and he loves it. So I'm here this afternoon to tell you, brothers and sisters, let it be what you do always. Every day, every week, challenge God to perform on your behalf. Challenge God to do things on your behalf. And as you do, you find out that your life will be filled with the Lord. By His grace, we say this month of September is our month of manifestation of God's glory. The only way I will manifest the glory of God, you will manifest the glory of God, is when you begin to take your place like Joshua did. And begin to make those bold statements of faith, those bold declarations, and say, I will consecrate myself. For I declare that tomorrow, that God will do wonderful things. You say, not first consulting God, saying, God, this is what I'm going to say, oh, you better do something. No, you don't have to. He loves you. Why? There's a general saying that if you can say something, then you can see it. I don't know how many of you have heard that general saying. Say, if you can say something, you can see it. They actually picked that saying from the Bible. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, is it unto him that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly, above all that you can ever imagine or ask or think, and not added another thing, according to the power that worketh in us. According to the power, which means, brothers and sisters, another word, literally, explaining that Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, is, brothers and sisters, if you can think of anything, if you can conceive anything in your heart, God can bet it. That's another way of saying it. And again, many of us, we have, whether good or bad, we have conceived things in our heart. And we've actually seen results. So I'm here to challenge you this afternoon, don't stop. What's the next level that you want to go to? What's the next phase or chapter in your life? What is it that you want to see? Just keep challenging God. And as you do, you'll find out that God Almighty, He will not let you down. He will always be there to ensure that none of His word that you and I will speak will fall to the ground empty in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Mark 11, 23, Mark 11, 23, the Bible tells us, is there with God? Let's look at it. Things are possible. And one of the things you also learn from Mark 11 to the verse, so verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in thou, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass. The Bible says, he shall have whatsoever. Let me say something on this Bible verse. Many of you have read it a lot of times. One thing you can easily see from this Bible verse is that it didn't say whosoever shall dialogue with God first. And before speaking to the mountain, mountain be thou removed. Is it that mountain removed? You don't have to talk to God about the mountain first. He said, for verily I say unto you that whosoever, anyone, irrespective of your age or when you got saved or your tied to a church, shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed. You don't need to even talk to God about it. As long as you are acting in line with His word, He said, just declare, like Joshua did. He said, consecrate yourself. He said, for tomorrow, God will do wonders among you. And I pray that you and I will continue to live that word in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Another good example is Mary. The Bible tells us in Luke chapter 1, verse 38. Mary, the mother of Jesus, when the angels came to him and told him all the beautiful things, you know, there are so many ways that Mary could have reacted. She would have said, okay, let me go and think about this information given to me quite a lot. Let me see. Like, you know, I'm married, but I'm not really married yet. I'm betrothed to this man called Joseph and all that. Mary could have said all sort of things. But if you read Luke chapter 1, verse 38, Luke 1, 38, the Bible says, Mary said, behold the handmaid of the Lord. He said, be unto me according to thy word. And the angel, the Bible says, departed what? From her. That's again Mary doing exactly the same thing that Joshua did. Joshua did not consult with God. When he made that declaration to the children of Israel, he said, consecrate yourself, guys, for tomorrow God is going to do wondrous things for you. And I believe there's someone here this afternoon. And I'm also here to announce you that God Almighty, the God that never sleeps nor slumbers, is going to do something glorious in your tomorrow in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And can I also quickly say that tomorrow can actually be the next 3 hours. It can be on Monday. It can be the next week. It can be next year. But we'll talk about tomorrow. Tomorrow is always a future thing, it's futuristic. But it can be the next 30 minutes, which means as we share the grace that we are going home, it can be your tomorrow. Tomorrow, Monday, 10th of September, it can be tomorrow that God is talking about. So you must be able to recognize it. So important that every day you are holding on to the word of God, making that strong declaration by faith that my tomorrow will always be okay, irrespective of what I'm going through. I'd like to also today look quickly at some few cases. There's a dear man of God in the Old Testament called Isaiah. In Isaiah chapter 45, he made also a reference to what we are looking at this afternoon. Isaiah 45, we're going to read verse 11. Isaiah 45, verse 11, he made a very bold statement there by the Holy Spirit. He said, "Thus said the Lord, the Holy One of Israel, is made, he said, ask of me things to come concerning my sons and concerning the work of my hand. God is actually moving his step away from the level where Joshua was. When Joshua made a bold declaration of faith by saying, tomorrow we are alright, guys, now God is challenging you and me that not only was what Joshua did the right thing to do, he said, guys, ask of me. In other words, every challenge that you and I will face is an ask of me for the solution. Ask of me for the way out. Ask of me on how to go around. He said, as you do, guys, you can rest assured that your tomorrow will be found. And I pray that your tomorrow will be found in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, when you ask of God anything, you are committing God to perform. You are saying, Lord, you have never failed before, and you will not start with me. Take for example, in Genesis chapter 18, verse 10. Genesis chapter 18, verse 10. This will actually lead us to pray some Bible prayer this afternoon. Genesis chapter 18, verse 10. The Bible tells us, this was God reminding Abraham of what he's going to do. He said, and he said, I will set the return unto thee according to the time of life. At this point, God was saying to Abraham, say, Abraham, your tomorrow will be found. I will return to your tomorrow. I will divinely visit your tomorrow. He said, I will set the return unto thee according to the time of life. And Lord, Sarah, thy wife shall have a son.